Now let's look how to do a cylindrical integral, sorry, a surface integral in cylindrical coordinates. Let's do the same plate we did before, which has 4 coulombs per meter. Well, let's decide which of the surface integrals we need. We know that we're going to be doing a double integral, and we're going to put our function, 4 coulombs per meter, in our double integral, and we need a ds term. Is this going to be scalar, or is it going to be vector? Because our function is scalar, our ds term is also going to be scalar. Now let's see what's changing. On this plate, is my radius changing? Yes, indeed. My dr, my radius, right here, is definitely changing on the surface of this plate, so dr is not equal to 0. How about d phi? Phi right here is always equal to 90 degrees on the y-axis, which means on the yz plane, phi is always equal to 90 degrees, so d phi is equal to 0. How about dz? Is dz varying? Yes, dz is definitely varying, so dz is not equal to 0. Now let's use this information and let's go over to look at the ds terms. So I can see that right here, my d phi is equal to 0, so this one goes away. My d phi is equal to 0, so that one goes away. And right here is the dr dz term that I can use because my r is not 0 and my z is not 0. So ds is just going to be dr dz. All right, so what does r go between? R goes right here from 1 to 4. Here are the r values. So r goes from 1 to 4. Now how about my z values? That goes from 1 to 3. So I'm going to end up with 4 coulombs per meter times r from 1 to 4 times z from 1 to 3, which gives me my 4 times 4 times 3, which is exactly the same that I had before. Now let's consider what some of my other surfaces might also have looked like. What if instead of that surface, I was interested in a surface that was shaped like part of this tin can? And let's say that its radius is 2 meters, and that it goes from phi equals 0 to phi equals 90 degrees, and that z goes from 0 to 4. Well, this integral would also be a double integral. I would put my 4 coulombs per meter squared on. This should have been squared. Should have been meter squared on all of those. 4 coulombs per meter squared here. And then what is changing? Is my r changing here? Here, dr is equal to 0. So this one and this one go away. There's the one that I'm going to be keeping. So my r is going to have r d phi dz. Phi is going to vary from phi equals 0 to phi equals 90 degrees, or pi by 4. My z is going to vary from 0 to 4, and my r value is set right here at 2 meters. That's going to give me 4 coulombs per meter squared times my r, which was 2 meters, times my phi, which goes from 0 to pi by 4, times z, which goes from 0 to 4. That would be my charge for this front surface. So notice that what I did in all the cases, the first thing that I did was I defined my function and I decided what was changing, what changes. And I used that to define the ds term that I used. I decided if it was vector or scalar based on the function that I wanted to integrate. And then I just set up my integral using the ds term over here.